Anyway, I destroyed the sound disintegrator. That menace has been removed. I wonder where they can be taking the wing. If we can make Bert talk, we'll find out.
Rise into the stratosphere before you set your course for our number two base.
I tell you, Bert, the law may show more leniency in your case if you give us the information we want.
What can I say when I don't know anything?
What about my brother, Gordon Tracy, who disappeared 2 months ago?
All right. What about him?
All right, boys, take him away. I'd give a fortune to be able to locate the headquarters of the spider ring.
This is very bad, Gordon. Burke is yellow at heart, and if they sweat him, he might talk.
Burke knows we have made arrangements to get him out. He will keep his mouth shut.
Then we can go ahead with our plans?
They are already underway. This time there will be no interference.
Did you get anything out of Burke?
No, not yet.
Does he know where your brother is?
If he does, he isn't telling.
But it doesn't seem possible for a man like Gordon to disappear without leaving some trace.
Oh, well. It'll work out somehow. I'd like a new radio, Junior.
Oh, gee, Mr. Tracy, it's 12.
May I come in?
Certainly, Commander Brandon. Come right in.
Oh, hello, Junior.
I guess we'll have to postpone this, Gwen.
How do you do, Miss Andrews?
How do you do? Won't you sit down, Commander?
Thank you.
Well, is this a business call or social?
Business, Dick. The steamship Mauravania docks this afternoon, one full day ahead of schedule.
Well, there's nothing so bad about that.
No. But the captain radioed that he expects trouble on his arrival.
What kind of trouble?
Furs. Valued at $1 million. The captain believes they're aboard his ship and that there will be an attempt made to smuggle them into the country.
I'm afraid I wouldn't be of much help to you, Commander. You see, that's out of my department. Besides, I'm concentrating on the spider ring right now.
I'd feel a whole lot better with you on the case. I hope I have better luck next time.
Thanks, Commander. Thanks for asking me.
Thank you. Goodbye, sir.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, sir.
Sign off now, but stand by for any message regarding the Moravania.
Do you suppose that was China, Mr. Tracy?
Certainly sounded like it. What does your log chart say?
Well, that's the funny thing about it. There isn't a single station listed on that wavelength.
Well, that's too low a wavelength for an established station. Sounds like Russian or Hog Latin or something. Maybe it's one of them Fiji Islands, is it? Say, you know that might be Fiji. Down to Fiji Islands. You know where they do that dance out of the...
Lockwood.
Something turned up, Steve?
Yes, this package was sent to the jail for Burke, so I brought it right over to you.
Let's examine it in the laboratory.
Can I go with you, Mr. Tracy?
No, that may be an international spy sending a message in code. You stick by the radio, Junior.
Gosh.
Junior, you better let me help you do that now.
Oh, no, you don't. Mr. Tracy told me to do it.
Gwen, I'd like to examine this in the X-ray.
And I'll start the machine.
Have you got the whistle?
The X-ray doesn't show a thing in any of them, Dick.
No, I guess not.
Hello, here's one that's been opened and resealed.
Where?
The fourth one from the right. Let me have it, Gwen. There must be something wrong here, or the package wouldn't have been tampered with. Disappearing ink on these, or it would show up.
Does that mean anything, Dick? It looks like a small pinhole.
Maybe you're right, Gwen. We'll soon find out. His men will be too busy getting a hold of them to free Burke.
If you'd only make Burke talk,
maybe he won't have to talk.
What's the idea of moving me to another jail?
It's orders, sonny boy. Get in. Far as you go, Burke.
Swell. Good work, fellas. Take this off, wise guy. Come on.
Stop that roadster and beat it. We'll take care of these guys.
Thanks. G-men.
The real McCoy.
You think we fooled Burke with it?
Well, he's gone, isn't he?
Thank you. I tell you, the spider's expecting me.
What makes you think so?
Listen, you don't think the spider would pull a jailbreak if he didn't want to see me, do you?
Oh, all right. I'll have somebody take you out to him.
Out here in a lodge. There's a man with him. He says it looks like Bert.
Bert! That jailbreak was slick, Chief.
Those G-men were as meek as lambs.
We had nothing to do with it. You were not supposed to be released until tomorrow. You'd better be on the level.
Why, I am. Something's wrong. Someone slipped up somewhere, Chief.
You ain't getting nothing on it.
Just the same, he told me to.
Ouch. Calling Mike McGurk.
Calling Mike McGurk.
That was Mr. Tracy.
Calling Junior. Hello, Junior, can you hear me? Now you know.
Well, if it ain't Dick Tracy. We didn't expect to get you this easy.
Now that you've got Dick Tracy, I suppose you intend to keep him prisoner on this
tramp steamer in the river basin. Maybe we won't bother keeping you very long.
Police know all about the abandoned boats in this river basin. They know all about the Mauravania and the $1 million fur deal, too.
And Mike McGurk is right now telling Steve Lockwood to have the police boat
meet the Mauravania before it docks.
Why, you... What?
Why didn't you let me?
Not yet. Tie him up.
All right. Steve's going to the dock.
He is, huh? Say, we got to get on my motorcycle and get down to that dock before they leave. Come on. The Mauravania is entering the harbor. The wind is just right for a smoke screen.
Get the men to their places with gas masks. Have the smoke machine ready for immediate action.
All right, man. Get to your boat. Be right with you.
Come along.
He won't give us any more trouble, Chief.
Start the smoke. Now shoot the gas through.
Thank you.
They take that hole. Come on.
We can't make it through there. We'll be killed.